Billy came to us with the idea of doing a sequel to 1979. He sort of felt that somehow Musically Perfect was a relative of 1979. The basic premise of the video is that it takes place 5 years after the first one.
A lot of people, when they heard Perfect, they said it reminded them of 1979. I thought, well, why not revisit the same thing, except maybe now the people from 1979 are on drugs, messed up, pregnant, and whatever else. So we struck upon the idea of getting the original cast back together, which we successfully did, I believe, 4 out of 5 people. There's only one problem. One of the guys was in jail.
And so everyone's grown up, and a couple of people are married, and some are in college. It's really about these parallel moments that happen in one evening, where these people are all over the city, and their paths cross, but in stupid little ways.
Kind of the most fun scene in it was the band filming in what actually used to be The Mask in LA. It was an old punk club in the late 70s and early 80s.
All the graffiti was there from 20 years ago. It was amazing.
We packed it with kids and we built kind of a big light box that they performed on. And then we had these cameras that were on the 360 turntable. So they kind of turned so you could see the whole space, and then it changed direction, and there was a really good energy to that stuff. It would have been a good thing just to cut the whole video in there.
In 1979, I sang from the back of a car, so we wanted to do something similarly as interesting, almost as an observer. So somebody, probably Jonathan, seems like one of his ideas, came upon the idea of me sitting on top of a crane approximately 150 feet above sea level, which didn't really bother me. And you know, you see the crane, you think, well, it's pretty high. Oh, and by the way, they want to spin the crane around and shoot me flying around Los Angeles.
I don't know if it looks as dangerous as it felt, but we got up there and it was kind of spectacular looking, but it was really dangerous. And Billy did an amazing job, but I think he was terrified. And I
petrified.
Think that we shot the next day and he was not himself. I mean, I think it really took a tremendous amount out of him.
There's only been a few times in my life I've ever experienced this, but my body went into complete physical fear shock. My whole body was shaking from the fear of being that high. I actually have a fear of heights, which I never told anybody about. I was scared shitless up there.
When this dad character is on his way home, he's watching someone being chased by a cop and he doesn't look where he's going and he goes headlong into the cop. And we did this elaborate thing of smashing the camera through a windshield, and we had to blow out the windshield with explosives, and he's supposed to fly over the cop car and land on the pavement. And it's far short of a John Woo film. I do like the cut to the hamburger patty on the grill.
I love the idea. It's just somehow we didn't quite get the execution right.
It might have been like too abstract. I think the problem with videos is that songs are really short and are supposed to be played on the radio, and stories take a long time to tell. I like it, it's a cute video, but I don't know if it really told all the stories really well and if people actually could follow it.
It's almost like a video you have to watch about 3 or 4 times to see what actually happened. Maybe even watch 1979, then watch this video back to back.